Alright you guys, Christmas just came early because today I'm spilling all the tea. So the long and awaited video that you guys have always been asking me for, and that is all about my pump, my silicone injections, whatever you want to call it, illegal butt shots. I've been delaying this video only because I wasn't sure if I wanted to get another session of pump, aka ass shots. We're gonna call it pump. We're just gonna call it pump. My goal was to finish my entire ass and then make a video about it, but at the rate that it's going, I won't be finishing my ass anytime soon. However, I do want to get this video up and out there for you guys because I know every day girls are getting pumped and I'd rather this video be out there so they know what to expect than just delay it up for my own vanity. Now, I'm not going to disclose her name only because this is something that's very illegal and I don't want to put her life at risk. Therefore, I will not be disclosing any names. So you guys, I would appreciate if you guys stop asking me who my pumper is. I'm not gonna tell you. I don't care how much you pay me. I'm not gonna disclose any information about my pumper, and that's that. So with that being said, let's jump right into it and start at the very, very beginning. How did I meet my pumper? So I was first introduced to pump during junior year in high school when Eden was getting pumped with Miss Alexia. They were in the room getting pumped together, and that's when I met the pumper for the first time. Nikita and I were in the restroom. We were kind of just like crouched down, like watching it all go down, hearing it, because you can just hear them like screaming in the back. And Nikita told me, she was like, isn't it crazy what like girls do? Like the amount of pain they go through to get body. And I was like, oh my God, yeah, that's insane. But I have a confession, bitch, I'm padding. And that's when I took out my hip pads and I kind of just like put them on her. And I'm like, try them on. I'm like, girl, look at you with body. Yes, you look good. After Eden got pumped, Alexia got pumped. 1 week later, Nikita had body. And I was like, oh, she got pumped too. That didn't take long at all. Nikita had one session and later she just kept getting more and more throughout the years. I just kept seeing her body blow the fuck up. And so I called her and I was like, hey girl, since like you just got pumped, like, can I ask like, how does it feel? What's it like? Like, tell me, cause I'm really curious. And she was just telling me like, hypothetically speaking, if I were to have gotten pumped, cause she kept keeping it a secret, I don't know why. She's kind of like, I would say that the pain level is like this, it feels like this, it feels like that. And I was like, okay, thank you for letting me know, because I was considering it, but I was just so scared of the pain. I was so terrified of the pain. And so years go by and these two are just getting pumped some more, like the three of them. Alexia's getting pumped some more, Eden's getting pumped some more, Nikita's getting pumped some more. Her ass just keeps getting bigger every fucking year. I know what was happening and it was something that I kept debating, because every time I threw on my hip pads, I hated it. I hated how much restrictions I had. I couldn't wear certain skirts. I couldn't wear a certain dress that are short because my hip pads would show. Like basically I would be, it was like a drag queen status. Like I would have to carve out these hip pads and just shove them in my thighs every single time. I never padded my ass though. It was always my thighs because I wanted curve. I didn't really care about an ass. I just hated how much restrictions I had when it came to like wearing clothes and just like certain things. And like I couldn't wear like shorts because triangle pizza body would show, and I'm kind of just like, oh, I hate this so much. So flash forward to this year around January, I was still padding, January 2020, but I met Zahira, and Zahira got pumped. She had about like three sessions in already, and I was doing the sessions later on. Zahira had about three sessions, and so she had like a pumped ass. And so being around that, I was just kind of like always watching her ass, like talking about it, asking her all these questions, and I was kind of just like, oh my God, like I'm kind of getting convinced, like I kind of want it now. Now, the girl who pumped Zahira is also the one who pumped Eden and everyone else. And so keep that in mind too. And so there are other trans girls that I've seen online in the area for like, I've known them for like years. And I would ask them like, oh my God, wait, who pumped you? And they'll be like, oh, this person pumped me. And I'm like, oh my God, that's the same person who pumped every bitch that I know. And so I'm kind of just getting all like the guinea pigs together. I'm kind of just like, okay, I'm seeing what's happening. I'm seeing their asses. They're still alive. They're still breathing. Knock on wood. Thank God. And so Victoria is watching Zahira's ass, and Victoria's literally convinced. Victoria's like, I'm over padding. Like, at this point, it was just me and Victoria who are left padding. So Victoria sees Zahira's ass, and Victoria's like, oh my God, I'm sold. I wanna get pumped. Like, let's get pumped. And so, flash forward to, I think, July or June, around there, Victoria got her first session, Zahira got her 1,000 session. Victoria's getting pumped, I'm watching it go down, and I'm kind of just like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God! And I'm kind of witnessing it, and I'm like, this is so crazy. And so Victoria's kind of just like, oh my God, Alina, please get pumped, please get pumped, please get pumped. And I'm like, I was prepared for it, but I was like asking the pumper, and I was like, do you have any more leftover product in there? Because if you do, then I'll get pumped right now. At this time, Bianca was getting pumped too. So the girl who got me into escorting, she was getting pumped also. So I was kind of just like, oh my God, all my friends are getting pumped right now. Why aren't I getting pumped? I felt left out. the pumper did not have any product left, and she was like, sadly, I do not, I only brought enough for these amount of girls today, and I'm out. And I was like, maybe it's a sign. Maybe it's a sign that I shouldn't have gotten pumped. Maybe it's just a sign. I'm gonna take it as a sign. So I didn't get pumped at all. But then I was kind of telling the pumper, I was like, you know what? I'll give it 1 month. I'll see how I feel in like a month. And if I'm down, I'll contact you again. But if not, then like, there's your answer. And so I was just so scared for the whole month. It was one of the most stressful months ever because I kept thinking like, Elena, do you really want a pad? Like, do you really, you went 5 years of your life padding, just limiting yourself, wearing to only pants. Like, do you really want to keep doing this while all your friends are having a grand time shaking their ass and just like being like themselves and just like wearing whatever they can? Like, do you really want to keep padding? Do you want to be the only one that's still padding? Do you, Elena? And so I'm kind of just like, oh my God, no, I don't. And so 1 month goes by. Danny and I are planning a trip to go to Solvang, which is like a 2-hour drive. And we booked our hotel and everything. And I was kind of like, you know what? I'll get pumped. I'll tell her right now. And so I messaged my pumper and I was like, hey, listen, like the next time you're free, like let me know. I want to do it. And she goes, well, guess what? I'm in your area. I just finished pumping 2 other girls. I can pump you right now today. And I was like, oh my God, wait, what? No. I mean, you have to think about this. And she was like, well, I'm in your area. I can just pump you right now. And I'm like, fuck. All right, fine. So that's what I'm like. Can you know, just come over. Just pump me today. Fuck it. But my trip to Solvang was literally the next day. And so I called Danny and I'm like, Danny, I'm literally about to get pumped. Can you please come over? Because I don't want to do this alone. Like, I'm so scared for the pain. The reason why I delayed getting pumped for so long was because of the pain. Because you're not numbed. You're not anything. She just kind of just goes right into you. But I'll talk about that later. And so I'm kind of just like, oh my God, I'm so scared. Like, I don't want to be alone. This is happening. I don't want to be alone. Danny, please get here. So Danny books it, hauls ass over here. Makes it just in time for the pumper. But then again, Danny was literally no help. Because Danny left me to go do her makeup the entire time. So I was alone. Now, let's get into how the pole pumping situation works. She gets to your house. She's carrying a bunch of stuff. And she lays out a doggy pee pad. Like, a doggy pee pad. I'll show you guys right now. It's literally just, and she lays it on the bed like that. She just lays it down and you lay on the pee pad with your stomach on it. So your ass is up. And the whole pee pad is for, you know, if any product, like, honestly, this is such a smart idea. Like, bravo to her. I would have never thought about that. But like, it's just in case if any blood leakage or just like silicone leakage comes out of your ass, it's going on here, not your bed. Honestly, props to her. I never would have thought about that. I'm laying there and I'm kind of just like, oh my God, it's really about to fucking happen right now. Am I really about to get pumped? Like, I'm so scared for the pain. So I'm terrified. I'm like, at this point, I'm like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Too late to back out now because she's already here setting up. So she puts on her gloves and just sanitizes my whole entire butt cheek. And like, my first session, I had it on my hips. So I didn't do my butt only because she usually distributes half of the product, half in your ass, half in your hips, and she just keeps building up by then. But I was kind of just like, you know what? I want to see results. And because I've always pad my hips and never my ass, I don't really care about my ass. I really don't. And so she's sanitizing my hips. I told her I want it on my hips. And so she is pulling out this big glass bottle. It's like the Voss water bottle. They have that glass bottle, and it's just filled with just silicone. It looks like clear oil. Like, the consistency is like an oil. It just looks like oil. It's slippery like oil, but apparently I think what she uses is medical grade silicone. So she pours that into a smaller cup and she has her syringe and oh my God, it's just so scary. I'm like reliving it again. So I'm laying there and she basically, here's how it works. She goes by the price. So there's the $1,000 session, the 500 session and the 1500 session, which is the highest she offers, because most people will pump and just keep going until you get to your final product in one sitting, and that's not good. So my pumper, she breaks it into portions. That way she lets your body adjust to it first. She lets you heal with it. She lets your body stretch out. And then once you're at like a good recovery stage, she will pump you again when she thinks you're ready, which I think is really good because people out here just be pumping people for the money, but she's actually looking out for the girls too, which I think is super, super sweet. I mean, she's sanitizing my ass and then Lord and behold, she pokes me. So the first thing she does is she stabs me. She kind of just like squeezes. She's squeezing him and then I just hear, boop, and I just feel the needle going in me. And at that point, I'm kind of just like, oh, it's like the subtlest like pinch, but the needle is so thick, you guys. Like, keep in mind, the needle is really, really thick because it has to be enough to like push oil through. The needle is really thick and she just punctures it in me and I feel the needle going in. It hurts for like 2 seconds, 2 or 3 seconds, it hurts. But once the needle's in there, the needle's in there, and that's it. Once the needle's in there, she pulls back to make sure she doesn't hit a vein. So she's pulling back to see if there's anything coming back, and if there's no blood drawn, then she's good. If there isn't, she'll poke another hole. So she pokes me, pulls back, make sure everything's fine, she doesn't hit a vein, and then she starts to load my body up with silicone. And during this process, it just feels so interesting. It's like this tight pressure feeling. It doesn't hurt. It just feels like your muscles being stretched, and like it just feels like muscles being ripped. I wouldn't say it hurts. It's just a lot of pressure. It just feels like it's like an feeling, you know? The only thing that hurts would be the needle going in, but the product going in is like a different kind of like feeling. It's not painful, it's just really, really taut, it's tight, it's just a lot of pressure. But that pressure can just get, it's an uncomfortable feeling. That's the word I'm looking for. It's uncomfortable. So it's really, really uncomfortable. And it's like a, oh, fuck feeling, you know? And so she's pumping you and then she stops. So she unhooks the tube from the needle, and then the needle is still in you. She just unhooked it. And then she'll take the tube, put it into the little jar, fills it up again, twists it back on, and just keep pumping that same spot. Now, she's not just pumping one specific spot over and over and over and over again. She's pumping one spot, taking the needle out, poking another hole. She's like creating multiple holes throughout your whole entire body to make it even and distribute the product evenly. So after she's poked about like 10 holes in my left hip and then 10 holes in my right hip, and just kind of like, she's poked so many holes at this point. This whole process is about like, I think 1 hour and 30 minutes. Of just pure pumping. So after she's done, she will take a piece of paper towel and she'll take super glue and kind of just like put glue on the paper towel and then like plug the hole. That way no product leaks out, because the needle's pretty thick. The needle created a fucking hole that's gonna be like enough for the product to travel back out if it really wants to. So she plugs the hole and then she puts a band-aid over it. And so at this point you have just kind of like a bandage up booty. Basically, you have like little holes. Think of the Grinch. You know how the Grinch first shaved his face and he has like the little like paper towel, like little marks? He has like the little paper towel, like bandages all over his face. Imagine that, but on your butt and on your hips. Basically, that. So there's like multiple holes, multiple bandages. It's just like that. And then she tells you, don't walk for 2 weeks, don't walk too much, do things around your house, but try to always be in your stomach. Let the product sit, because your first session, it's kind of just like there's nothing for the product to grab onto, so it can just easily drip all the way down if you are not taking care of it. So she's kind of just like, don't walk too much, just lay on your stomach and just like let the product sit and heal for 2 weeks. And I'm like, okay. She goes, no heels, no anything, just relax. And I'm like, okay. So once the pumping session's over, there's no pain. You know there's product in you, but you're not in pain anymore, you know, because the product's already in you. So she leaves and I'm kind of just like on bed rest. But me and Daddy had a trip to go to Solvang the next day. I didn't want to cancel my trip, so I said, fuck it, let's go. So the next day, me and Danny got into the car and I am sitting on my stomach. Athena's sitting in the front seat. We drive for 2 hours and we get to Solvang. I'm on stomach duty again. And so I'm like walking around at this point, like just not even giving a fuck. I'm like, bitch, I'm just gonna keep walking around. Like, I came all this way. I want to see the town. I want to see this cute little town. And Danny told me, she was like, Alina, just because you can't feel it, like, going down doesn't mean it's, like, affecting you. Like, you need to, like, sit the fuck down. And so I'm like, okay, fine. And so the whole weekend, I'm, like, walking around town, living my grand life, just not giving a fuck at all. And as the swelling goes down, I'm noticing that my hips are kind of gone. Like, they're there, but really, really minimum. And so I'm like, oh my god, all my hip session is down in my thighs now. And so I kind of dropped a little bit because that's my fault for not listening. But what can you fucking do? So 3 days later, Victoria's getting pumped and I'm like, oh my god, I want to pump my ass now. And so I asked her, I'm like, hey, my first session you put it on my hips. You didn't really touch my butt. Can I get my butt done? And she was like, technically you can, because I never really touch her butt, you're right. And so she was like, all right, I'll do your ass. So 3 days later after my first session, I got pumped in my ass. The ass is a different level of pain. I'm laying there and I'm just kind of like, oh my god. Like, it's just the muscle there. It's just because your hips don't really have any muscle, but your ass does. And so she's like poking me, and every time she pokes my ass, my butt flinches and it gets hard and tightened. And at this point, whenever my butt does that, she's like slapping it. She's like, relax, relax. Because every time the muscle tightens, it makes it harder for her. Every time my muscle on my ass tightens, I can just feel the product. This is what it feels like. Imagine you're flexing your arm and someone just takes a needle and stabs you. In that flexing muscle, that's what it feels like on my butt. It was one of the most ouchy feeling ever. Like getting pumped on my ass, much more painful than getting pumped on my hips, honestly. And the reason why I haven't done my ass again is because of how painful it was for me. And so I'm kind of just like, oh my god, ow, 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 ow. And every time she's pulling my ass, I'm just like, I want to fucking cry. I want to scream. It just hurts so bad because the ass is just so sensitive. And then she'll pump with the lower butt cheek. And that hurts so much, you guys. Like, oh, I'm like shaking just thinking about how painful it is. A lot of girls handle this pain really well because they're kind of just like, the body, like I'm doing it for the body. So they sit there. But for me, I just hate pain so much. It's more than I can bear. So I'm getting my ass done and then she pumps my ass. And then once she pumps my ass, I'm kind of just like, oh my god, that was so painful. Like, I don't want to ever do that again. Like, that was so, so painful. So she pumps my ass. At this point, I've gotten 2 sessions in the matter of 3 days. And so I'm really on recovery. So the whole month, I'm recovering. And then 1 month goes by and I'm like, oh my god, can you please pump my hips because they're all gone. When that one time I just kind of kept walking. So she was like, yeah, pump your hips. It's been a month, I'll do it. She comes back, she pumps my hips. And this time I really, really see the hip. And I'm like, oh my god, I have a body. And I really start to see the figure. And I'm like, this is amazing. Oh my god, I have body. And this is like the happiest I've ever been. Because I've always been self-conscious about my hips. And so like now that I'm actually seeing like a figure, I was like, oh my god, like, this is beautiful. Like, I should stop here. I look natural. I don't look overdone. I look beautiful. And so I'm recovering, and this hip session really turned me out. Like, I see the body. Like, before it was kind of just like you feel your hip dips, but now it's like I see it. My body is changed. This is a new body. Like, this is it. And so I'm letting that session heal. So after a month goes by, I'm healing. And then once I'm fully healed with my ass, I decided, let's get my boobs done, because why the fuck not? And that's when I got my boob job vlog, so I posted that, so you guys can look at that. I'll link it down in the description box down below if you guys want to see that. So that was when I got my boobs done, and then I'm kind of just like on bed rest and recovery for like a month. After my third session, I was happy. So my sessions were, I had 2 1500 sessions in my hips, and I had 1 1500 in my ass. So my ass wasn't as voluptuous, but it was a little something, better than what I had before. Now here's the tricky part. Because I had so much product in such a short amount of time, I had this thing called leakage. So basically, I had so much product so soon, I didn't allow my skin to stretch and heal properly. And so whenever she would poke me and she would pump me, whenever she left, I would have a lot of leakage because there was just so much product in me. I never allowed it to like settle in. And so I would leak. I would be laying on my stomach healing, and then I would touch it, and then all of a sudden I feel like all this oil and just the silicone, and I'm like, oh my god, I'm leaking. And so product dripping out of you, dripping out of you, dripping out of you. And I'm like, oh my god, like I need to plug this shit because I'm losing all this product coming out of my ass. And so I'm like texting her, and I'm like, oh my god, what do I do? What do I do? What do I do? And she's kind of just like, here's what you do. Just walk through the steps. And so I'm like plugging it with like a tissue, but a few minutes go by and it'll still keep leaking. And so at one point I kind of just like over it, and I took Gorilla Glue, I wiped the hole, and I just went and I squeezed all this glue directly into the womb, the open womb. Now, we're all familiar with super glue. It's like a liquid and then it dries up like a crystal and it's hard. And so I had the glue go into my womb. So this is a hole, okay? And this is my inside of my flesh. So I put the glue right there, and the glue went into the hole and it plugged it. It plugs it completely, but now the inside, there's glue. And so when it dries, it becomes this hard crystal. So I have baby flesh in me. It's baby skin inside me, and I have this liquid that just turned into this hard crystal. And so as soon as it dried, it would poke my little baby skin inside, and it would hurt so much. Every time I got up to move, I can feel the crystal of the glue just poking my inside flesh. And that was the most painful thing ever. And because I put so much glue directly onto my skin, it burned my skin. And so I have like burn marks. It literally looked like if someone literally smoked a cigarette and just ashed it onto my skin. Like, it's burned. and it's there. It's like a little mark. It's really subtle. No one sees it though. Like, you have to like really look for it. That was one of the things I hated the most about getting pumped, which is the recovery. And I would leak a lot. I would leak so much product all the time because there was just so much in me. I hated the leaking product and I hated just dealing with the whole leaking thing, because sometimes I'll have some womb close up in like 2 days and then I'll have some holes that will be leaking for 5. Honestly, it's not a fun feeling because every time you're laying and you don't know if there's product leaking out, you don't know what's happening. You kind of just always have to like eyeball it all the time, just feel for it, just know if you're leaking or not. And like, you don't feel it coming out. You kind of just have to touch it and hope that nothing's coming out. So yeah, with that being said, my ass right now, I have a total of 2 sessions of 1500 in my hips and 1 1500 session in my ass. And so I've only had 3 sessions. And do I plan to get more? 100%, of course, only because I do need more in my hips. Keep in mind, you guys, that I do know the risk of getting silicone injections, but the reason why I was so confident in getting it was because all the girls that I've seen get it from the same lady, they're fine, nothing bad has happened to them. And so I was more like convinced. I was like, well, I mean, Nikita's fine, Eden's fine, like Zahira's fine, and like all these other girls who've had their pump for like years are fine. And I'm kind of just like, they're out here living their grand life and I envy that. I want that. And so desperate times come to desperate measures, and I know the risk. You guys don't have to tell me. I did all my research. I was Googling. I was watching all these silicone injection videos gone wrong, and I knew what I signed up for. But in that moment, I just knew I would be happier with the body that I wanted, and I did it. And I know you guys are thinking, why don't you just get a fat transfer? Bitch, I'm skinny as hell. Like, what fat are they gonna like put over into me? And even if they did find some kind of fat, it would be the smallest amount of difference, and it would cost like so much more than the amount that I've gotten just pumped. And so realistically, I just got pumped. I'd rather build my ass than go through anesthesia again and just deal with that all over again. And just, I'd rather just keep building my ass knowing like it's an instant result and I'll get the body that I wanted, rather than putting out so much money and in hopes for the best the doctors find some kind of fat on my body to give me the body that I have today. Because if I were to go in to get a fat transfer, you guys, I would not have the body that I have today. It would be minimum. It would be like a really light curve. It would probably be like my first session. It would cost so much more. But I saw all my friends get pumped, and so I was sold, and so I did it. Anyways, that's what I want you guys to look out for. Like, I remember when I first got pumped, I was kind of just like, what the hell did I just do to my body? Like, because when I first got it, it looked like blocks. It looked like bricks in my body. And I was like, oh, what did I do? But then the next day, once the product kind of just settles in and morphs into your body, it becomes a smooth little figure, and I'm like, perfect. But I did document all of this. I documented the raw footage of my blocky brick ass and my brick hips, and just how it looks weird and how like the first few days look. I documented my first session, my second, my third, and just like I documented like 1 week later, and I did everything. It's all my OnlyFans. I would post it here, but I was nude in a lot of the footages, and so I can't put that here. But I have a full vlog of just documenting. You see my bandages, you see my leakage, you see everything. I raw footages of everything. I put it together. It's on my OnlyFans. If you guys want to see that, I'll leave a link to that in the description box down below. It's onlyfans.com/Elena Genevieve. So you guys want to see that, go ahead and check it out. But anyways, I wanted to make this video because you guys are always talking about it, and I feel like every trans girl has pumped. No one ever talks about it because they're scared and they don't want people knowing they got pumped. But like, there are so many girls out there who are doing it anyways, and I just want to inform them what to expect and what to prepare for. Keep in mind, in no way am I condoning this. Am I saying go out there and do it? I'm just giving you my experience. But I know there are girls out there who will do it no matter what. They will find out how to do it, they will find the way, and they will do it. And I'd rather them be aware of what's gonna happen than just, you know, block it off and keep it a secret. I'm not one to hide about anything that I've gotten done, only because I want to educate as much as I can out there, because I am kind of like your guinea pig. I kind of transitioned, you know, you guys witnessed my whole entire transition, you guys witnessed everything, you guys witnessed my boob job, you guys witnessed my ass, so like, I really have nothing to hide. Yeah, I'm not condoning this, you guys. Just keep in mind, get this at your own risk. Like, you know what's gonna happen. And if you guys don't, watch this video so you guys know what to prepare for and look out for. Keep in mind, there is a thing called stainage. And it's when, like, it's like an oil stain. So like, over the years, your body will turn a little purple, only from all the silicone. I mean, it has happened to some girls and some, it just looks like a permanent bruise, but purple. That just kind of happens if you don't take care of it. I mean, each body's different. Zahira doesn't really have that many stains, but I know some girls who does have a lot of stain on their ass. I haven't had any stainage, knock on wood. All I've had is stretch marks, that's it. But it's a lot of stretch marks because I never allowed my skin to stretch out properly. But anyways, keep in mind, those are all that you're gonna have to look out for when you guys get pumped. If you guys are really that desperate enough, you will find a way. And the thing that my lady used is medical grade silicone. It's safe to be in the body, but it's just not recommended to put that much. So for example, I looked it up and it goes, medical grade silicone means the silicone has been tested and approved by the FDA for biocompatibility. So it's designed to be worn safely inside the body for long periods of time. Medical grade silicone is hypoallergenic, latex free, and contains no toxins, and is also non-porous and so resist bacterial growth. Therefore, I'm not saying, oh my god, you guys, put it in your body, it's fucking safe. I'm just saying, like, the product she used is much safer than what some pumpers may use in different states. So make sure you always know what's going inside your body. Do your research. If this pumper has pumped other people, ask them, see their results. Like, just ask around before you guys do anything. Like, don't be desperate enough to just get pumped by the first person you can find. I did my research on my pumper. I've known her for many, many years, and I watched her kind of just, I watched her test subjects just walk around, and like, I asked her all about the product, and and that's what she uses, and I looked it up, and I did my research. So that's that. With that being said, you guys, give this video a big thumbs up if you guys learned anything. If you guys have any questions, leave it down below, and I will make another video just answering all these questions for you guys. All the information I have given you on my ass, if you guys want to see the raw footages, swipe up. I mean, if you guys want to see the raw footage of me documenting it, it's all my OnlyFans. I'll link it down below. But anyway, so video for my tits, check. Video for my ass, check. And if you guys tune into my next video, I will be discussing what I got done to my face to look like this. And that's something that I have never ever talked about for so many years. For about, I think, 5 years, I've never discussed what I've gotten done on my face. But I feel like because it's the season of giving, I might as well just spill all the tea for you guys. So stay tuned for next week's video where I discuss what I got done to my face. Anyways, you guys, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Give this video a big thumbs up if you guys enjoyed it. And until my next video, bye guys.